الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We have already spoken about the first principle, the first fundamental principle, which is the question, who is your Lord? And the response to this, as we said, is our Lord is Allah, and He is the one who we worship, because He alone is the Lord, so we worship Him alone. And we mentioned a variety of worships, which includes worship of a worship done by the heart along with the worship done by the body parts. So there are some worship which are exclusive to the heart, such as fear, hope, love, trust, and so on. Then the second fundamental principle, what is your religion? Our religion is Islam, and Islam, or this religion, has three levels. The first level is Islam, the second level is Iman, and the third level is Ihsaan. Islam has five pillars: Shahada, Salah, Zakah, Sawm, and Hajj. We discussed the Shahada, La ilaha illallah, there is no God, there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. We said it has two parts, negation and affirmation. And then testification of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam being the messenger of Allah. What does the testification mean? When someone testifies, I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah, it entails that he should obey the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in whatever he has ordered, and he should believe in whatever he has given news of. He should keep away from whatever he has stopped, and he should not worship Allah except by the means that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught or prescribed. The reason for this is that even the sunnah, or even the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is like wahi. وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. And also Allah says in Surah Al-Hashr, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the messenger gives you, take it. And whatever he stops you from, then you should stop. Then after Islam, we have the second level, Iman. Iman has six pillars. The first pillar of Iman is to believe in Allah, then to believe in the messengers, his books, his angels on the last day, and to believe in fate, good and evil. And the evidence for this is also in the Quran in a number of places. And these are the six pillars of Iman. Again, when we say believe in Allah, what does it entail? It means a number of things. To believe, first of all, in the existence of Allah. And then to believe in that Allah alone is the Lord, is the creator, sustainer, and cherisher. And then to believe and actualize that He alone is worthy of worship. That means, because as we have stated earlier, that because He is the one who deserves worship, we should worship only Him. And to believe in His names and attributes. And that He is alone with regard to His names and His attributes. This is the three levels, or the three categories of Tawheed, which are overlapping. And if any one of them is missing, then the Tawheed is incomplete and the person falls into shirk. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. Allah will not forgive a person who dies upon shirk. So, what are the three categories of tawheed? Tawheed al-rububiyya, tawheed al-ibad, and tawheed al-asma wa-sifat. Tawheed al-rububiyya and tawheed al-asma wa-sifat have majorly to do with the belief. We believe in tawheed al-rububiyya and we believe in tawheed al-asma wa-sifat. These are the asma wa-sifat that belong specifically to Allah, which cannot be given to anyone except for Allah. And we have to believe in them. You cannot reject them. And similarly, we believe that Allah is the Rabb, as we mentioned earlier, that when we say that Allah is the Rabb, we mean He is the Malik, He is the Malik, He is the Khaliq, He is the Malik, and He is the Mudabbir, the disposer of affairs. Then what it means, Tawheed al-Ibadah means, because of the same reason, we should worship Him alone. So what regards the actions of Allah, such as creation and sustaining, that is Tawheed al-Rububiyya. Allah is the Rabb. Rabb means the one who has done all of these actions. Now when he was doing these actions, or when he does his actions, does he require help from anyone? Did he take help from Jibreel alayhi salam, or did he take help from Isa alayhi salam, or did he take help from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? No. Now when we are going to worship, should we worship any of the creations, or should we worship Him alone? We should worship Him alone. So when we say La ilaha illallah, ilah means the one who is worshipped. So when we do the action, that is when we do the worship, we should worship Him alone. So this is belief in Allah. And then the belief in the messenger, belief in the books, belief in the angels, belief in the day of judgment, and belief in fate, good and evil. And finally, the third level of Islam is Ihsaan. Islam, Iman, and then Ihsaan. And how many pillars does Ihsaan have? One. What is the pillar of Ihsaan? أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. That you worship Allah, that you worship Allah as if you see Him. فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَى فَإِنَّهُ يَرَى. Then if you do not see Him, of course nobody can see Allah. Even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam has not seen Allah. فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَى فَإِنَّهُ يَرَى. Of course you cannot see Him, but He definitely sees you. And this can also be proven by a number of ayahs in the Quran. And what is the evidence for these three levels of the religion? The three levels of religion, Islam, Iman, and Ihsan, can be proven through the hadith, which is very popular, which is narrated by Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. And this also shows us the status of the Sahaba, that in order to learn the religion, you have to pass through the Sahaba, whatever the Sahaba have taught. You have to pass through that. You have to pass through the narrations which have been narrated by the Sahaba. So Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu has narrated to us the hadith which is commonly known as the hadith of Jibreel. Because in this hadith, it is mentioned that Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the shape of a human, and he asked him about Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. And through this we know the three levels of religion. And this hadith is narrated by Imam Muslim in his Sahih. So these are the three levels of religion. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.